Okay, so the first story I'm going to share is from Dr. Kuo-chun Lee, who graduated with a PhD degree from USC in 1994. He's now working as system engineer at Qualcomm in San Diego, US. Well, this is a recent, very recent picture of Kuo-chun, and we are very, very thankful for him because he's one of the sponsors of this event. So I'm going to share the story that he sent me. All right. Here it goes. Looking back to 20 years ago, I was guided by Professor Lee at the Communication Science Institute of USC to receive a PhD degree. My PhD thesis topic was on all optical networks. I'm very grateful to Professor Lee's guidance to my thesis and study at USC. Therefore, my PhD process has been the most successful experience in my whole life. In fact, some of the publications co-authored by Professor Lee and I has been the most representative research papers in the entire field. After graduation in 1994, I started my career in the industry. Since then, I continued to work in the wireless industry for nearly 20 years as a system engineer. I have worked in the companies of Qualcomm, Ericsson, and Huawei. I am currently with Qualcomm in San Diego, California. I have worked on development of various cellular products, including CDMA-based station systems, WiMAX-based station systems, and etc. In the last 5 years, I have worked on the 4G LTE mobile device communication chipsets. The recent products I'm working on have been used in the popular mobile phones, such as iPhone 5, Samsung Galaxy F5, S5, and etc. So what I learned from Professor Lee in my PhD study has brought me many positive influences. Although I'm not a researcher or researcher in the university anymore, I constantly use what I learned from Victor in a PhD setting into my work. My PhD training helped me think thoroughly and be able to create systematic solution and use analysis to optimize the performance of my job. From time to time, I use my PhD research training to create interesting and innovative ideas. By Kuo-chun Lee from San Diego. Let's give him a hand for him. All right, the next story I'm going to share with you is from Dr. Cherng-Shung Simon, who graduated with a PhD degree from UNC in 1992, and is also a system engineer in the protocol system group, Qualcomm, in San Diego, US. So he and Kuo-chun are now colleagues in the same company. So here goes the story. Oh yeah, sorry. Oh, this is a picture of Simon and his entire family. Simon has a really large family. From the left to the very right, we have Eric, which is the son. Oliva is the younger daughter. And Jackie, older daughter, that's in the middle. And then Simon's wife, Rayer, I think that's the pronunciation. And that's Simon. So this was taken about a few years ago, well, I think 1 or 2 years ago, at his daughter's wedding. So you see someone's getting married, they look very happy. All right, so here goes the story from Simon. I entered the PhD program of EE of USC in May 1998, and graduated in May 1992. Due to the limitation of financial aid from my company in Taiwan, I must complete my study within 4 years. It's much appreciated that Professor Lee realized my situation and provided me the necessary and valuable guidance and assistance to achieve my goals. Professor Lee often invited his students to their Arcadia home during holidays. We all enjoyed many wonderful evenings with his family. After graduating from USC, I returned to my company in Taiwan to work for additional 8 years. With the recommendation and help from Kuo-chun and Irfan, they were also students of Professor Lee in the USC, I could join Ericsson in San Diego as a system engineer in August 2000 to develop CDMA 2000, BSC, and BTS. 5 years later, I joined Media FLO department of Qualcomm in San Diego to develop TV broadcasting system and mobile terminals. The performance of our FLO system seemed to be better than DVB-H. However, the department got closed. due to the slow market growth. It's very unfortunate. And then I joined the QCT of Qualcomm in San Diego in November 2010 until now. I'm now working as a system engineer in protocol system group for protocol support for LTE, WCDMA, and IMS, etc. Kuo-chun and I are still colleagues in the same group. I have been living in San Diego for 14 years. I love San Diego. Now I leave my wife with an empty nest. Every day is busy and challenging. I'm thinking when I should retire to feel my wife and my plans. For instance, spending more time on taking care of my old parents in Taiwan, visiting old friends, worldwide, touring, and many more. Well, Victor is not retiring very soon. All right, so this is from Simon in San Diego. Let's give a hand to him for sending this article to us. And the last, but probably the best story I'm going to share you today is another senior brother. It's actually a couple. From Dr. Chih-ping Wang and Dr. Cherng-Shung. This article is written by, this is Chih-ping, their daughter Marita, and their son, I forgot his name. I think it's, let me check, sorry. Very talented. I think the name is, hang on, sorry about that. I should have probably memorized that thing. Is it wrong? No. Okay, I'll get back to you later. I really can't find the email. But anyway, this is their son. His son is graduating from high school this year, and he's entering a law school. So they really wanted to come here, but they can't because their son is moving to the East Coast this summer. So they have to help with the relocation as parents. So Chih-ping, who graduated from USC in 1998, and is now a senior development director at Oracle AICT. And Sherry is right now an individual contributor to Apple Inc. All right, here starts the story, very long story from Chih-ping. All right. My dear teacher and thesis advisor, Professor Lee, has a 60-year-old birthday soon. Instead of emphasizing his remarkable academic and career achievements, I'd love to take this opportunity to write down some personal experiences and interactions that I have had with Victor to celebrate this big day. I am extremely fortunate to have been one of the many PhD students of Victor has guided. I was under his advising from 1994 to 1998 at USC. I first met Victor in his 1984 computer network class. I was really impressed by his intelligence. He was still in his 20s and looked even younger than many of my fellow classmates. At that time, he already had many publications, was one of the most popular teachers in the WE department. Victor's acceptance of me as his PhD student was, to my surprise, uneventful. There was no quiz and no interview. I asked him if I could take me, and he simply said, okay. During the course of my PhD studies, I really appreciated that Victor gave me a lot of guidance, not only in finding my thesis topic, but also in equipping me with the ability to analyze and solve complex issues. To this day at work, I still apply the methodologies he taught me. There were a lot of fun memories concerning my interaction with Victor during my years at USC. Here I just randomly list some as they come to my mind. The first one, Victor's most lasting impact to my daily life. When I go to a supermarket, a bank, or anywhere with a waiting line, I always count the people in front of me when I enter the line and count the people behind me when I reach the front of the line. I feel good. The lines become longer or else I feel bad. I started to do this thing after learning a little theorem, the queuing theorem, from Victor's queuing theory class. Second, things we used to do, but not anymore. The first one is cut and paste. Oh, really? Well, I meant the real physical cut and paste using scissors and scotch tape. Back in my time, conference papers require cutting from a laser printer output and pasting to the template mat from the publisher. Finding out that the paper was accepted was always a joyful thing. Victor usually announced the good news first in a one-on-one session. Then we would still need to print out the final version and do the cut and paste. I was really bad at doing the cut and paste. I could not tell if the line was slanted or curled once it was getting late, and there were still many pages to go through. I looked at my work and simply said, I think I can do a better job. And he started helping cut and paste the rest of the paper. I really appreciated the kindness he showed me on that day. And second story, projectors without a video input port. It was before the time of laptops and tablets. At that time, projectors were used with transparencies. We used this equipment a lot in Victor's weekly group meetings, where we took turns presenting our research papers. I think Victor used this as a way to focus us to practice reading research papers, and to acquire better presentation or discussion skills. Victor was always able to get to the core value and arrangement of each paper. He also started many good discussions about presented paper. I personally enjoyed the presentations very much. At that time, half of Victor's students worked on network-related topics, and others worked on database-related topics. This meeting provided a very good forum for us to learn beyond our research focus. I also learned that a way to make people asleep is to put a lot of words on one transparency. Well, luckily we still have the group meetings right now. And then, here are some memorable events provided by Chih-ping. The first, promotion. I remember a day Victor was promoted to associate professor. Now looking back, it may not look like a big event given Victor's other later successes. But at that time, it was a big thing. I remember the department had a huge celebration that day. Victor was all dressed up and smiling. All his students felt very aesthetic too. And another story, Victor's new Mercedes Benz. I know that later, Victor had another Mercedes. But I believe I saw this first one. Many of his students had the honor to be in his car. In my case, Victor drove with me to ACM PODS conference in San Diego. Back to San Diego again, okay? It was a unique opportunity for me to stay with my advisor for a few hours. Victor really liked his car, and he took very good care of it. And there are some happy times that Chih-ping sharing us. Victor was very serious about his work, but outside work, he was very humorous and approachable. Victor hang out with the students a lot. We went to lunch in nearby Chinese restaurants. We played board games like Risk together. We also had potlucks together several times. He was always very humorous, telling funny real-life stories all the time. His Hong Kong accent and Mandarin made his story even more enjoyable to listen to. And here's my biggest thanks to Victor. Not too long after I joined Victor's research group, he took another student named Xu Chen. She was beautiful and intelligent. To cut the chase, Xu Chen and I have now been married for 27 years. For this, I owe Victor a lot of thanks for bringing Sherry. I believe Xu Chen and I are the first married couple to both of Victor's students. And he showed us a picture, but it's not here. It's somewhere on the web, we can find out later. Okay, it's a wedding picture in 1988 during the wedding of Sherry and Chih-ping. And this is all from Chih-ping Wang, who's now in the Bay Area. Thanks for listening. Please give a hand to Chih-ping and give a big hand, although they cannot really hear the applause. But to all of people, our senior family members, for writing me this article to share with us. Thanks.